Hello everyone, it's Brian Akeem here, and today I'm going to be bringing you an awesome video. Let's rumble, let's get this started. This is going to be going over the top 10 best fights in the Walking Dead universe. This is just going to be on AMC's universe. I am not going to be including Telltale Game fights or the comic fights. This is strictly just going to be AMC fights. So yeah, guys, let's get this started. So there's a couple of rules with this for my top 10. I have one honorable mention. So for the rules of this fight, the top 10 fights, it's my personal opinion. Let me know what your list is down below and what you thought of my list as well. So the way the fights work is that they're going to be how much I enjoyed them, how much did they impact me, how much did they impact the story. Two characters fighting, like I said, it's not a battle. It has to be at least two characters fighting each other. And, you know, it has to be a fight, you know, it can't be a battle like with guns per se. It has to legitimately be a sparring match, a fight. So for honorable mention, number one is Rick versus Shane, the final fight between Rick and Shane. So this is why it's an honorable mention. This is not technically a fight, but it is a verbal fight. Rick and Shane shouting at each other, you know, Shane tricked Rick into going out into woods, pretending he killed Randall and made it seem like Randall escaped. And, you know, he says that he's going to kill Rick as good a place as any. And he draws his gun on Rick, and Rick is surprised. He's shocked. And Shane kind of brings it up that it's just too late. They can't go back, and the world has changed. They've both changed, except for Rick. He mentions that he can protect Lori and Carl and the baby. And Rick and Shane have a kind of a shouting match where Rick is just telling Shane that, you know, you can't live with this and all this stuff. Like, for the first two seasons of The Walking Dead main show, Rick and Shane have been butting heads. Despite these guys knowing each other since high school, the fact that these guys were basically brothers, it was too much of a head. Shane just wanted to take control of the group. He wanted to be the leader. He changed the apocalypse too early, and he wasn't willing to, like, wasn't willing to help Rick and them, kind of thing. And, you know, he wasn't willing to be diplomatic anymore. And Shane was 100%, I guess, in a way, ready to kill Rick at that time. But Rick tried to talk Shane down, and he kind of did. He was surrendering his gun. And I believe it was stated, I could be wrong, but wasn't it stated that Shane was actually believing Rick at this? He took his gun. Because why else did Shane not immediately shoot Rick? Like, you know what I mean? Like, but yeah, it's just absolutely crazy that Shane might have, like, you know, not killed Rick, and then Rick kills him. So it's just absolutely crazy that Rick finally kills Shane. He kills his best friend, and Shane dies. He's stabbed, you know, by Rick, and dies choking on his own blood. And it's a brutal death, impactful, but it's an honorable mention because it is not technically a fight, you know. So yeah, so for number 10 we have Rick versus the Governor. So yeah, Rick versus the Governor was a pretty good fight in The Walking Dead. It wasn't one of the best, but it was very impactful because this is Rick and the Governor, Philip Blake. After two seasons, we finally get to see Rick and the Governor fighting, like, literally face to face, like, at each other, which, you know, it's not really something that even happened in the comic per se. And yeah, it's just honestly absolutely crazy that this is, you know, what happened in the Walking Dead TV show in Too Far Gone. Rick was, his leg was grazed by a bullet, and he was beating up the Governor for killing Herschel, but unfortunately the Governor was stronger than him, got the upper hand, and started beating Rick. Rick was beaten bloody, man. It was just like it was very invincible, like, think Rick, think, you know, moment here, because yeah, the Governor was full on. He was straight up killing Rick. And Rick definitely would have died 100% if it wasn't for Michonne. Like, Rick definitely lost his fight. And then Michonne stabbed the Governor with her katana, finally, more or less, well, not exactly finally, but putting an end to him. Because yeah, man, I was blown away with when this happened. Like, Rick lost the fight against the Governor, and Michonne saved him by killing the Governor. And it was just an awesome fight that happened in The Walking Dead. So for number 9, we have Beta versus Daryl, or I guess I should say Daryl versus Beta. So I think this was one of the best fights in The Walking Dead, television universe, because it kind of starts out with just Daryl killing a random whisperer, you know what I mean? That's one way it kind of starts out. You know, Daryl has an axe, and he just kills a random whisperer, and then all of a sudden, this wall just bursts open, and then you have Beta, which, oh my goodness, it was really funny, and honestly incredibly crazy, because Beta is such a powerhouse. Like, he was in the comics. He was like 7 foot at least, I think. But, you know, obviously in the show, Ryan Hurst, you know, was like 6 foot something, 6 foot seven, I think. So, you know, it was kind of changed up a bit. And yeah, Beta versus Daryl, Daryl versus Beta. Beta was way stronger than Daryl. And also, the thing is, this was a crazy fight because Daryl, I don't think he's ever really fought anyone like Beta. And they have each have double knives. And then, you know, Beta puts Daryl against a saw and asks him where Lydia is. There are a couple. This is a very impactful fight in the Walking Dead universe because it's something I always wanted to see, and you know, the fact that we got it was just absolutely crazy. But there are some things that kind of hinder this fight that don't make it perfect. Like I said, the choreography for this fighting was good. I liked how Daryl was more agile than Beta. I think that was a good use of Daryl's skills. But there's a couple of other problems with this fight. Like, one is Daryl was just too perfect in this fight. You know, he was just too amazing. Like, he didn't even get like a black eye or something. Like, come on. But Daryl did outsmart Beta. Beta thought he was hiding in this like elevator shaft or whatever. And then, you know, it's so crazy because Daryl just straight up pushes Beta into it, pushing him down and seemingly killing him, but obviously we know Beta didn't die. But yeah, Beta fell through like two stories or something onto an elevator and was really injured by Daryl. And you know, so Daryl did unfortunately win the fight. I mean, he did, like, fortunately and unfortunately, because I did wish that Beta kind of messed him up a bit more, just because I was really looking forward to this fight. But so I think it was still really good. And for number 8, we have Rick versus Pete. What can I say about this fight? This fight was not, why is it better? Well, one is because this was back in season 5, back when The Walking Dead was in its prime, you know. In the second half of season 5, you know, Rick and Pete, they were kind of building up this tension between them, but really it was more of Rick kind of wanting Jesse, I guess you can say. But obviously there was a whole abusive relationship between Jesse and Pete, you know, the marriage that had abuse in it. We didn't get to see it, but obviously it was confirmed. You know, Rick versus Pete, it was very different. In the comic, you know, Rick was the first one to throw the punch at Pete at the door, whereas in the show, Rick was a little more diplomatic next to Jesse. And Rick and Pete are just clawing at each other, slamming each other against the walls. And I love the part where, even from the comic, they have it where Rick and Pete go out through the window. It's pretty iconic, and it's something I'm not sure how it happened. But it was, you know, awesome. And, you know, this fight is also one of the reasons why, like, if you guys remember, I added something like this in Extinction, in my Walking Dead, you know, Extinction universe, you know. I was very heavily inspired when I watched this fight with Rick and Pete, because this fight's one of the most impactful fights, I guess, in The Walking Dead, because it really shows Rick's character in Alexandra. In both the comic and the show, Rick and Pete are just bloody. They, in the comic, Rick whooped Pete, but in the show, despite the fact that Rick beat him, like, I do think that Pete kind of whooped Rick a bit. And also, you know, it's kind of crazy, because if you guys remember back in the, you know, the party episode, you know, Rick was thinking about killing Pete, you know, kind of thing, when he had the secret gun, and Jesse tried to stop Pete, and, you know, Carl tried to stop Rick, and Rick was strangling Pete and all that, and then Rick pulled his gun out to the community and threatened them. And this fight was just honestly so crazy. I remember it all those years ago. It was just so crazy. It was so crazy that even, like, Glenn just straight up disappeared. Like, you know, he disappeared next to Nicholas. It's just crazy. So yeah, not to mention Rick's speech. I'm also technically including that in the fight, because I think I do think it's kind of part of the fight, because it does involve Pete. You know, Rick telling the Alexandrians they're weak, they don't know how these things work, they can't change, they need to change with the world, kind of. Rick looked like a psychopath, just like in the comic, which was crazy. I loved it. For number 7, we have Paul versus the Whisperer. So yeah, guys, so this fight, you know, you guys remember in the mid-season finale of season 9, what about this fight? Like, you know, was it a fight? I technically include it as a fight, because Paul was fighting zombies. You know, he was killing zombies very well, and I'm including the zombies and the Whisperer in this, because the Whisperer was in there. And yeah, you know, Paul Rovia, you know, as some people call him Jesus, but I call him, I strictly call him Paul, because that's his name, and I'm a Christian. I don't understand why people call him Jesus. I mean, I get that he looks like how Jesus, like, looks in the Bible. Anyway, I'm moving on. Basically, what I'm trying to say is that I still don't understand why no one ever calls him Paul. But other than that, yeah, this fight was amazing. The choreography, you know, like, Tom, he did such a great job with his fighting skills, with the sword. Tom Payne. He was just fantastic in this fight scene. The music, the slow motion, kicking a zombie, flipping over, killing another zombie. It was just fantastic, man. I really enjoyed this fight sequence. It was just fantastic. The fog, like I said, the music was creepy, eerie. The characters in the graveyard, the whispers, it was just so good. You know, Aaron and Eugene and Daryl, you know, escape, and then all of a sudden you think he is going to join them. He's killing some zombies, you know, he's going to join them, and they're like, you know, we haven't lost anyone. But then, you know, obviously Paul thinks he sees a walker and he kills it. Like, it's funny, they showed him killing a walker just prior, and then all of a sudden it's like the next one is like, oh, it's a whisper, because the whisper, obviously, you guys know, he ducked and stabbed, he spinned and stabbed and killed Paul. You know, he stabbed him in the back and Paul died from the stab wound, which was just honestly so crazy. I was shocked when I saw this in The Walking Dead. Paul Rovia's death was not spoiled for me. The fact that Paul, one of the best fighters in The Walking Dead franchise, was killed by just one whisper, it just honestly shows the level of threat that the whispers had, the music and just everything. It was crazy, man. We lost Paul, man. Like, that was a big loss, man. That was a big hit for The Walking Dead group, the fighters, man. And not to mention he was the leader. The whisper was creepy. It was just so good. For number 6, we have Morgan versus Emil, the bounty hunter from Fear the Walking Dead season 6. I know, guys, that's crazy. What, Brian? You have a fight scene from Fear the Walking Trash? Yes, I know. It's ironic. Please just bear with me. This fight, in my opinion, was one of the best in the Walking Dead franchise, because I was at this point not really sure what was going to happen to Morgan as a character. I didn't really think Morgan had plot armor. Like Daryl with Beta, I didn't really think Morgan's plot armor could save him this time. You know, Lady James is a fantastic actor, not to mention, that character he met, Elijah, was helping him to fight Emil. Virginia set that bounty hunter after Morgan. This whole episode, Morgan has just been sick. He's been weak. The bounty hunter has been after him. So the fact that it comes to a head this episode with Morgan and Elijah fighting Emil, even Elijah putting in work to save Morgan's life, which is very rare for minor characters to do in The Walking Dead. You know, when a character is introduced and does that. Anyway, yeah, you know, Emil has killed a lot of people from what we can assume. And yeah, it's just, this was at a point in Fear the Walking Dead where, and obviously, as you guys know, Fear the Walking Dead season 6 is one of the better seasons of Fear the Walking Trash. Morgan fighting, you know, Emil, like, Emil has, you know, the whole axe that he has, and Morgan has his stick, and it's just honestly crazy. The fight, in my opinion, the fight is brutal. It's well acted. It's well done. You really get the sense that Morgan is going to die. Emil is way stronger than him. He's tougher, but it's just honestly so crazy. Like, Emil swinging the axe down, and it's like, I'm kind of there with Morgan. It's like, oh my goodness, that axe almost killed him. I mean, like, I'm kind of there. I'm kind of like, I don't know if Morgan's gonna have characters. This fight is brutal. It's dirty. It's unfair. It's just like, there's a lot of things about it that just, I don't know. It's well done, in my opinion, for Fear the Walking Trash. You know, like, Lenny James did a great job here. So did the actor for Elijah and Emil. This fight is dusty. Morgan gets the upper hand you know, he swipes Emil and then stabs him in the chest. I'm like, ah, yes, finally. I'm like, yes, Morgan, finally. Also, it felt so rewarding because this bounty hunter was after Morgan all episode, but also Morgan finally breaking his stupid no-kill rule, standing on top of Emil, realizing it. Oh yeah, by the way, Rachel was having her baby, you know, Elijah's wife. And, you know, Morgan has just had enough, because in my opinion, this point of the story, Emil was going to chase after them. He was going to kill them, never stop. So Morgan at this moment realized that there's only one way to stop you, and that is to kill you. And Morgan taking Emil's axe. I mean, finally, man, after like two seasons, Morgan finally breaks his stupid no-kill rule and kills Emil, chopping his head off. I'm like, oh my goodness, yes. I'm like, this is what Fear the Walking Dead's supposed to be, you know? So yeah, I really enjoyed that. For number 5, we have Felix Carlucci versus Huck, or I guess Jennifer Malick, from The Walking Dead World Beyond. So yeah, guys, why is this one of the best fights in The Walking Dead franchise, in my opinion? Well, you know, AMC's universe. Because I just think this fight was great. I mean, all season, you know, Felix and Huck have been friends. They've been trying to take care of the kids, you know, Hope, Iris, Elton, and... Hope, Iris, Elton, and Silas. And the fact that it all comes to a head, you know, realizing the betrayal that Huck did, betraying them, lying to them, manipulating them, injuring Felix, all the stuff that happened, the CRM, the lies, they found out she was a spy. The fight is just well done, in my opinion, because Huck is more trained than Felix, but obviously Felix is stronger than Huck. But, you know, like, it's just honestly absolutely crazy, you know, this fight sequence. They're literally trying to kill each other. Felix literally stabs in the wall to try to stab Huck in the head. It's just, like, it's so great. Even Felix rips off a cabinet door from the kitchen and then smacks Huck in the back with it. I just found that so hilarious. I'm like, I love how brutal this fight is. There's a fire going on, too, because Huck pushed Felix and that knocked a lighter, one of it knocked a light. But yeah, I love this fight because Felix was injured. Huck didn't want to kill him. There's just so much with this fight I really enjoyed. And I absolutely, like I said, I enjoyed it. It was well done. And it really mattered for the story. And for number four, we have Brandon Carver versus everyone from The Walking Dead Season 11. Guys, this might shock you, but this is one of the best fights I have ever seen in The Walking Dead. Because, guys, think about this for a second. It is one guy against three. Carver versus Negan versus Maggie versus Elijah. By the way, I think I said Elijah back in Fear. I meant Isaiah. So that was my mistake. But yeah, so obviously you guys remember with the Reapers and all that, you know, Maggie and Meridian, all that stuff. But the fact that we get this fight scene, this was well choreographed. I loved it. This narrow, small hallway where Maggie, you know, everyone is just swiping at Carver. You know, they are trying to kill him. They all have their weapons. They all have their skill set. Maggie almost took Leah out by herself. You know, that's how good Maggie is as a fighter. But Brandon, you know, this guy, it's just so great. You know, he takes Negan's bat and swipes him. Like, this guy fought three fantastic fighters in the Walking Dead, you know, universe. You know what I mean? Like, Elijah is one of the best fighters. Maggie has her plot armor. So does Negan. So yeah, this fight was great. It did a lot for the story. I loved how brutal it was, how bloody it got with Brandon, you know, Carver barely taking any hits, because remember, he's supposed to be an ex-military, you know, and he is just, he doesn't care. He's hitting everyone, and I love it so much. Okay, I love how brutal it is. I love how all the characters get smoked by Carver. I love how oh my goodness, I just love how brutal it gets with the punches and hits and cuts. You know, Negan, Carver pushing Negan to the ground and, you know, like an old man. It's just, I really loved how crazy it got. It was so chaotic. But like I said, it was well choreographed because Carver, he's fighting three people at one. He's fighting three veterans of the apocalypse at once. And it's just honestly crazy. I love how, like I said, I love how brutal it is. I love how it gets bloody. I love how, despite the plot armor, it doesn't feel forced that our characters got in a few hits or almost got hits. Carver, like I said, it's funny because when I was watching season 11, I didn't think Carver was that big of a deal. I thought that Daryl would kill him easily, but I just love it. He is just turning everyone into ragdolls. I found this so hilarious. Everyone in the scene needed to get pegged down a notch, if you ask me. Maggie was a terrible character. Elijah sucked. He was boring. And Negan, oh my goodness, he is an old man. Do I even have to say it? Like, come on. You know, Negan's swinging his bat. I'm sorry, Negan's like looking like Santa Claus, and you know, he manages to land a hit on Carver. It's so funny. I ate my words because, like I said, I didn't think Carver was that good of a fighter before we saw him. And then when we saw him, I'm like, oh my goodness, this guy might be one of the best fighters in the Walking Dead universe. I love how he hits Negan, and like I said, Negan is just like, oh, I am done. I am so done. Like, I love how he just demasculates everyone in this fight scene. I just find it so hilarious that everyone cannot, like, all three of them cannot take down this one guy. This is one of the Reapers, just one. And I love how Carver, he didn't even look, and he turned around and stopped Elijah from stabbing him because he knew. Like, I'm like, oh my goodness, this fighting is so well done. This is what I want in the Walking Dead franchise. I want to see a villain who's a beast of a fighter. I want to see a Walking Dead villain pull an Omni-Man on the Walking Dead characters. Like, come on. Like, this is something I want to see in the Walking Dead. It's so well done. It's great. You know, it's just fantastic. And, you know, Elijah is hurt with his leg. And I totally love how Carver just kicks Elijah down and just, like, injures him further. It just, I found that so hilarious. I'm like, oh my goodness. He didn't even look, I don't think. Like, I'm like, dude, this guy is a fantastic fighter. I, like, love this. I think it was fantastic. And the part where he's fighting Maggie and he jumps against the wall and hits her in the face. Like, we are going to get to that soon. But yeah, it was just fantastic. Like, this is fight scenes I want in The Walking Dead. Dead. This is what I want to see in stories, because this was one Reaper, one villain, one guy, and it's like, oh my goodness, like, he smoked everyone, and the only reason why he lost was plot armor and because Negan did just slightly outsmart him, but that's really it. I really loved this fight scene. It was so well done, and I have to give AMC praise for this. For number three, the mighty three, we have Felix versus Lieutenant Newton. So yeah, what did I think about this fight scene? Well, it was freaking amazing. Like, I have to say it. Now, some of you guys might be surprised. You're like, what? Another Walking Dead World Beyond fight or Trash Beyond or whatever? Guys, I love the World Beyond and I love the fights in it. World Beyond has some of the best fight scenes in the Walking Dead franchise. And that's for a fact. I'm sorry, but I don't think you can deny that. Okay, the fights are well done. And I love how Felix takes his staffs and makes like a Darth Maul, staff kind of thing. And like, Felix used walkers to his advantage to tire Newton out a bit. And I don't know who would have won with these two in a fair fight. But like I said, there was a lot with this fight that I loved. And how it mattered in the Walking Dead story and the universe, because like I said, this fight was very interesting and new. It gave me a lot of ideas for Extinction, because like I said, I like looking at these fight scenes and thinking of what could I do in my series, because yeah, these fight scenes are so well done, because not only is it just Felix and Newton against each other, but they're also fighting zombies. And sometimes the characters don't even look when they stab a zombie. There are zombies all around them. And I love how Felix is using the zombies as a shield. You know, he stabs a zombie, stabs another one, you know, with his staff, and so on and so forth. I like the creativity with this fight. I love how there's zombies around them. I like the characters they use, because Felix, we've grown to know him for two seasons, and I really like his character. I think he's one of the best characters from World Beyond. And you know what I mean? And then for Frank, Newton, I don't care for his character, but he's loyal to the CRM. And, you know, he has some history with Felix, which I don't really care for. But, you know, his fighting style is different because he has a knife and, you know, a baton. And Felix has a staff that has like two blades on the side. So I'm like, this fight is very creative. It's awesome. It's so well done. And yeah, this fight scene, it was so well done in my opinion. Like, can you guys honestly say this fight scene wasn't amazing? Because I really loved it. It was so creative. It was absolutely amazing. You know, these two characters just going at each other, the way Felix, you know, and Newton are fighting each other with their weapons, but also with their fists and their kicks. Like I said, this fight, it doesn't last too long, but it's very creative. And it's just like, you can kind of tell there's a time crunch. There's a lot of stakes with it, because we like Felix as a character. And also, we want to root for him. We don't want to root for the CRM, because the CRM are the bad guys in the Walking Dead universe. And yeah, you know, there's more to it. You know, like I said, with the walkers, I love how in this fight, Newton and Felix, they have to deal with the walkers here and there too. And I really love that. You know, it's not something like a timeout or something. They have to deal with these zombies while they're fighting each other. I just feel like that's a very creative fight in the Walking Dead universe. And it's not made in a ridiculous plot armor way. And I love how Felix swings his staff. I love how creative the fighting gets. I love how, agile Felix is with the staff. You know, how he spins it, how he, you know, flips it over, how Newton and Felix try to get the upper hand on each other. I love how, like, seriously, Felix is acting like some kind of Jedi or Sith Lord or whatever. I just love it so much. And he even stabs a zombie through the back of the head, through the front of his head, like, from behind. And I don't even think that was intentional. But like I said, this fight is so intense that they don't even notice. And, you know, Felix drags a zombie to, Lieutenant Newton. And it's just honestly like fantastic, like I said, because there's just so much with this fight scene that I really enjoyed. It's very creative. It's something that The Walking Dead I don't think has ever really done. And you know what I mean? Like, it's just, like I said, it's just fantastic, because they're fighting zombies. They're fighting each other. It's very creative. You don't know who's going to win. That's one thing. You know, there's no plot armor here. You don't know if Felix will die. You don't know if Frank will die. You just don't know. Felix spinning around his staff, killing multiple zombies, and then stabbing, Newton and pulling his guts out. And then, you know what I mean? It's just like, oh man, that was just such a well done fight scene. That was great. That was fantastic. Like, I have to give AMC props for that. And for the Mighty Two, we have Jadis versus Huck, or Jennifer Malick. So yes, another fight from The Walking Dead World Beyond. So guys, why did I love this fight? Well, it's important to the story it matters to the Walking Dead universe. I mean, we get, you know, the conversation between Huck and Jadis about trading Rick to CRM. And obviously, we're not going to talk about the ones who live. But yeah, like, I love the setup. I love how this was setting up the movies, revealing what happened to Rick. Because, you know, in this fight scene, we care about, you know, Jadis and Huck as characters. We want to know more about them. But then hearing about Rick, how Jadis mentions that she had an A, but she said he was a B. So Rick wouldn't die. So he wouldn't be a test subject in Elizabeth's lab. And I'm like, oh my goodness, this is so much information we're getting. Like, you know, I love this. And it also basically confirms that Heath is dead. You know what I mean? And it's the reason how Jadis became so high up in the CRM. She sold Rick like a piece of property, you know, to CRM. And Jadis, at this point, in my opinion, she is completely lost. She believes in the cause. She believes that what they did in Omaha was justified. The genocide of Omaha, she believes that it's what they have to do to keep this world going, that they have for humanity to survive. Jadis is completely lost it. She's mental. And I love seeing this because Jadis, we've seen her from the Walking Dead main show. And Hawk, we've seen her as a character too. You know, we've got to know her for 2 seasons. And she's really grown as a character. She was loyal to CRM. She was secretive and betrayed our group. But she learned that she was in the wrong, that everything she did, she now knows what's right and wrong. Whereas Jadis, like I said, she has turned to the dark side. She is evil and is just honestly crazy. Like I said, because Jadis was always a snake of a character. Like I said, this fight was so crazy because we want Huck to win, because we don't want Jadis to win, because if they do, you know, CRM wins, then they're going to destroy Portland too, and a lot of innocent people will die. So we're right there with Huck wanting to stop Jadis. We want Jadis to die for every horrible thing she's done. Jadis is too far gone. She's psycho. She's mental. You know, and we're hoping, and we hear a stab, someone gets stabbed, and we're hoping that it was, you know, Jadis that got stabbed. But then we find out a switcheroo. You know how Felix won against Frank? Well, unfortunately, in this version, you know, Huck unfortunately lost. Jadis freaking stabbed Huck, and I was just honestly so shocked by that. I'm like, oh my goodness. I'm like, they actually are killing Huck off. Like, we got to know her character for 2 seasons. And the fact that, once again, out of all the horrible things that Jadis has done, now we can add another murder on that list. Now we can add another character, person we lost, another life that was taken away because of Jadis. You know, like I said, this reinforced that no one is safe in The Walking Dead. It reinforced that Jadis is a complete monster. She's just too far gone. She's lost to the CRM. And it's just honestly so crazy. Like I said, we got to learn so much about the CRM. We got to learn about Rick. And in my opinion, like I said, we got to find out what happened to Heath. And why the CRM does the things they do. Like I said, we got to see how far Jadis was. We got to see Huck's redemption as a character. We got to see her finally come full circle as a character, sacrificing herself to destroy the gas so that everyone in Portland could live and stop the CRM. And this actually buys them 2 more years, Portland 2 more years of life. So, you know, before the whole Rick and Michonne thing. So yeah, like I said, this fight scene was just well done. It was amazing. And there were high stakes. You know, and I didn't expect it. Like, it was well choreographed, and for the story, it really mattered. Like, because I was on the edge of my seat with this fight, because I wanted Jadis to lose. But no, she actually technically won. But although she lost because the gas exploded. For number one, the best fight in the Walking Dead universe is Rick versus the Claymores. So yeah, obviously, we know that it's Rick, Daryl, and Michonne versus the Claymores. But yeah, I mean, come on, like, this is honestly just one of the best fights in The Walking Dead, because Joe and his group, they ambush Rick and Michonne by surprise, but Daryl is with them, and he tries to convince them that, you know, to let Rick and them go, but Rick killed Louie or whatever, so obviously they want to kill Rick, and now they want to kill Daryl. So it's just one of those things where Rick does the absolute crazy thing of biting Joe's throat out, and it's like, oh my goodness, Rick, you monster, you bit Joe's throat out, that was fantastic, that was amazing. Like, dude, like, this was one of the best fights. In my opinion, this was the best fight in The Walking Dead. And there were some fists being thrown, but it really showed the level of savagery with Rick as a character. And we finally got to see it. I was on the edge of my seat. My brother Robert, he was shocked by this scene. It's one of the best fights in The Walking Dead. It's a very short fight. And it's like I said, there's not a lot of fighting, but how it impacts the story, how well acted it is, how brutal it is, the music, just everything, like, it's from the comic, it's so well done, and that's why I think it's number one. So yeah, guys, that's going to be it for my list. Let me know what you thought of my list down in the comments below. Let me know what your list is for the top 10 Walking Dead fights in AMC's universe. Like I said, do you think some of these fights were the best? Would you have rearranged some things? Would you have included another fight I didn't have on here? You know what I mean? Maybe Rick versus Shane and 18 Miles Out. You know, there's a lot of fights in The Walking Dead, you know? Which ones did you feel like were the best? Because yeah, guys, with The Walking Dead, man, it's always fighting. Heck, it's even fighting itself, you know, and even the fan base fights. But obviously, let's be respectful and not fight with each other about what's the best fight. But yeah, guys, until then, that's going to be it for my video. And I hope you all have a great day. And yeah, like I said, I hope you enjoyed the video. And I will see you all guys next time. Take care. Bye.